How are you, Dominators? Hopefully you're fine. It's finally, oh dear, it's finally time for another episode of Dominations. So what am I doing currently? Currently, I have to do a lot of raiding for oil. Most Cold War Age players should know this phenomenon, because the university upgrades as well as, or the university researches, as well as the upgrades in the blacksmith, the armory, costs so much, so fucking much oil. It's about 300 up to 400,000 oil daily at some days, at other days only 100 up to 200,000, and this task sometimes overwhelms me. So the Emperor Haile Selassie research for the rocket arsenal nearly is finished. I have to do some more 100, 300, 400, 500,000 oil to get finally the capstone, but this will last some time still. In the armory I have unlocked the heavy tank Mark 7, and this will be the next research I want to finish. So 120,000 oil to go for now, and after this I will focus to the commandos, because you may have recognized since the last patch or balance update or whatever, the commandos or their statistics, their values have changed, and now they are not only surpassing gates or sneaking through gates, they are also not triggering anymore any traps, which makes them very valuable if you are using them wisely. I tried a couple of attacks in alliance challenges, also in the world war, and currently I'm trying to figure out whether it's better, or which tactics constellation or how, which tactics to play with them is fits for my playing style or how I want to use them in the best way. Currently I'm preferring the sabotage tactic against or versus the decoy tactic, because decoys are triggering traps, and I am pretty sure those triggered traps with the decoys will also harm and affect the commandos afterwards. But nevertheless, commandos are pretty interesting. My ones are only at global stage, so I have to research them to get their best value or the best value out of them. Nevertheless, I have tried them a couple of times in alliance challenges, and now we have a world war which was pretty much won, and therefore I also tried them in the world war. So before we will go to the multiplayer and go for some more heavy tank raids, I want to show you those commando attacks in the running world war, and I want to try to explain sideways what was my intention by attacking those players. Keep in mind, my mercenaries are Atomic Age, my planes are Cold War Age, my generals are, I don't know, Industrial, Global Age somewhere, but my commandos are only Global Age. So the enemies I'm attacking don't have the best base layouts and also not the best strong defenses, but compared to my commandos it is not that much difference. Let's go first for enemy number one. Most of the defense buildings over here are industrial stage. We have very strong air defenses. And I try to first rally my commandos for an air defense, and afterwards take the commandos very, very to get them right around the base, to have their maximum effect by not getting them accumulated up, so they are not staying at one stage and being one bunch of troops which are all attacking for the same building. I tried to split them up. That was the word I'm searching for. I tried to split them up, and then I tried to work with sabotage as well as blitzkrieg. When the air defenses and towers have gone, now I'm able to use my planes very without any hesitation to get rid of the defenders, which are harmful to the commandos. The quick victory with 50% of the base are pretty easy by this commando tactic. The only thing which is critical is to use the sabotage tactics in the right moment, so from the point of time, and also at the right locations. Because the sabotage tactics I'm using 2x assault rally and 5x sabotage, have to be deployed at the defender spawning buildings, especially tank depots, bunkers, if it is their rocket arsenal, we don't have any over here, town center, and probably also at some garrisons, to avoid most of the defenders. In this case, I also had an offense collision, which is level 3 and which gave my commandos and bazookas some kind of more health. But yeah, for my first real attack, and you see I also only used the global age commandos, I think this attack was not so bad. Also, the time was not that bad. Now let's look at the attack at enemy number 2. Here we have most defenses at global stage. Really nearly all of them. So they are matching my commandos, which are also on the global stage. Now look how I'm using my sabotage tactic. I managed to get nearly all of the defender spawning buildings and avoid them from producing defenders. Not all, but nearly all. So my commandos could really easy and really efficiently work without having too much defenders against them. Now when most of the towers again have gone, as well as most of the air defenses, it is nearly no problem to use my planes against them. The only real struggle with commandos is to get all of the other buildings, which are not defense buildings. Commandos are dealing nearly no damage versus those buildings, so you also have to get some troops and make sure that you get at least the 100%. I'm using a bazooka commando tactic, which is quite common, I think. I haven't seen many attacks with commandos, but bazookas seem to me most valuable. Yeah. So the first attack was right around 1 minute and 40 seconds. And I think I was some kind of faster over here, even. So with the next world war attacks, no matter which enemies I will see, even if they are very superior to my troops, I will try to get for the commando tactic, because it's a new tactic and or new strategy to attack, and I really like it because it's some kind of changing or change and not doing all the time the same stuff. Only the retraining of troops before doing the world war attack is some kind of nasty. But I've talked already 7 minutes, now let's go to the multiplayer. We have currently the Sputnik event running, so I have to get 100% destructions, so 4 or 5 stars at least. Therefore I will also attack lower bases to make sure to get a lot of 100% attacks in. Okay, all traps are triggered. Let's go over here. I also used the commandos in the multiplayer, but that was a complete disaster, because they are dying that fast, and this is not efficient looting if you have to retrain commandos nearly after each attack. It is not about the costs, they are not costing that much, but it's about the time factor. So there's only a very few amount of attacks where you can raid without using that much other troops to get the 100%. Oh no, my tank is dying. Oh no, that was so stupid. What did I want to say? I wanted to say attacking with the commandos in multiplayer mostly results in getting the commandos killed, and then you have a lot of time to get them retrained, which makes it completely inefficient. For World War attacks, it is, yeah, a good opportunity. Okay, I should definitely pay more attention to the attack. If you are playing commandos, give me some kind, not an advice, but your opinion about how to play the commandos. Do you prefer the decoy tactic or the sabotage tactic? And I lost the plane, oh my god. Yeah, that is a perfect example how not to attack. When I'm really in what I'm talking about and the topic is interesting me, it's hard to focus to another point. Unfortunately, the another point is the raiding. So the first attack and I already lost the plane and the tank. But that's what I deserve when I'm not paying enough attention to the attack. But we will get 5 stars, so one attack closer to the last reward of the current event.
Yeah, troops are retraining. And that base seems valuable. When I'm starting with my heavy tanks in the multiplayer, mostly my target is to don't use any tactics as well as generals or, oh, I have another tank, or troops sideways, to only attack with my tanks which I can retrain, and also to don't use any tactics if it is possible. So when I'm starting at a base, I prefer to deploy my tanks there at enemy buildings which are harmful to my planes, and to use my planes obviously for enemy buildings which are harmful for the tanks. So if there are is a castle or a tower very cornered at a base, I try to deploy my I try to deploy my tanks close to them to get rid of the castle or the towers which are harmful to my planes mostly, and obviously to use the planes for the anti-tank guns or the cannon towers. Okay. So I think we should be through this base. If there are not any more remaining spike traps. Oh no! I lost another tank instantly when I was talking about not any more traps remaining. So that was stupid. I think I will make a short break after this attack, because attacking with three tanks makes absolutely no sense. The chance for losing any more tanks now, when I have only three of them, is quite tremendous. So stay tuned, I will be right back for you. Come on. Wow, this tank has really a lot not a lot of health anymore. So we are done. So we could craft some more artifacts meanwhile. A Welcro artifact. Okay, that's pretty bad. No, I have to destroy it, otherwise I cannot produce any more. Okay, the first point is pretty good. Second is okay. Third is bad. Fifth is fourth is okay or good. And the fifth is not that good. Also not that good. No, it's also not fitting my playing style. Same. That's unfortunate. But it feels like they have changed the artifact crafting system after having implemented the possibility to get artifacts from South America and the Aztecs and whatever. It feels like the artifacts have way less often the 11% attribute, as well as the good attributes are
are being created that much often. For only for example, I got that artifact exactly that wise. I only gained access to the second, third, and the fourth stage, but the air defense hit points, the catapult hit points, as well as the last air defense hit points, all have been in the this artifact. And this is an artifact which was pretty old, so before that patch. And now it feels like there are not that much good artifacts anymore. All of the artifacts have two, if not even three, bad and low percentage attributes. Not that good for me. Oil looted is okay, but 7% are low in some. Also not good. Nope. Point or attribute 4 and 5, guerrilla damage and fighter damage are okay, but the first three are nearly useless to me. Also not that good. So it feels like 99% of all attributes I'm crafting, I have to destroy instantly without even thinking about using them. Second attribute is okay. Completely bad, completely bad. Bad. Second attribute is pretty good. Third attribute is good. Fourth is good. Fifth is also good, but the first one already is bad. So this is not that bad, but I think I got already better ones. I only have to unlock. Bad. Also not good. Bad. So again, first one is good, second is okay, third is okay, fourth is okay, fifth is okay, nope, 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 no. So there was a 2-star artifact, but nevertheless, oh, we can do another 5. Unfortunately, not. Also not. No. No. And no. So, not a single one.
Perfect loot base. First aid packet, otherwise I will lose another tank.